Introduction to Financial Management. There are three main areas in finance. Number one, manager finance. Number two, investment. Number three, financial market. Effective utilization toward achieving the organizational goals. Number two, IM planning. Financial management is that managerial activity which is concerned with the planning and controlling of the firm financial resources. Number three, Lawrence J. Kidman. Finance can be defined as the art and science of managing money. Finance is concerned with the process, institution, markets, and instruments involved in the transfer of money among individuals, business, and governments. Arthur J. Q. David, Scott J. R. John, P. Mersin, and J. William Bitt. Financial management is concerned with the maintain and creation of economic value or wealth. Number 5, James C. Van Hoon and John M. with Owing J.R. Financial management is concerned with the acquisition, financial and management of assets with some overall goal in mind. Why maximization of shareholder wealth is preferred over profit maximization as the objective of a firm? Number 1, the time patterns of the return. Even though a large return is expected in 20 years' time, very few shareholders would wait that long to get the first return for the project. Therefore, shareholder maximization is taken as an objective of a firm. One manager must also consider the time pattern of the return. Number 2, risk. If profit maximization is taken as the objective of a firm, its financial manager will look for projects that offer the higher return without considering the risks that is associated with the expected return. Normally, the higher the return, the higher the risk involved. However, if a financial manager aims to maximizing the shareholder wealth, he will consider the risks involved because the risks the project undertaken, the market price of the stock may be less. Number 3, dividend policy. Firms which aim only to maximize the profit will never increase earning without favorable change in market stock price. However, when earning increase accompanied with payment of dividend, it will affect the value of the stock. Function of a financial manager. Number 1, performance financial analysis. A financial manager must be able to transform financial data into a form that can be used to monitor the firm's financial condition. Number 2, financial forecast cutting and planning. A financial manager must be able to estimate the future financing need to support the increase in production capacity. Number 3, financing decision. Make a deep analysis of all the available financing alternatives, their cost and their long-run application on the firm's financial condition. Number 4, making investment decision. Determine the amount and composition of current and fixed asset need to be held by the firm to run its business activity. Decision regarding the optimal level of each type of current asset and when the existing fixed asset need to be modified or replaced must be made. Number 5, asset management decision. A financial manager must manage the firm asset efficiently to ensure that the firm get most benefit out of this asset. Money market versus capital market. Money market is a financial market to raise short-term financing in which short-term instruments with high liquidity are being traded. Example are treasury bill, mutual paper, and banker's acceptance. Capital market is a financial market for buying and selling of long-term debt and equity securities. This market can be divided into primary and secondary market. Primary market versus secondary market. Primary market is deal with new issue of securities that involve the issue and the investor. The securities are considered new as it is the first time issued to the public or named as the initial public offering. Secondary market is after a security has been issued in the primary market, the investor might decide to dispose or sell the share that he or she had bought earlier. The investor may now approach his stockbroker and request for the disposal. The stockbroker then sell the security to other interested investors in the secondary market. Advantage of financial institution to the financial markets. Number 1. Reducing the time and cost of transferring funds. Financial institutions help to transfer funds for a capital from surplus unit to the deficit units, thus saving time and cost of transferring funds from one unit to others. Number 2, reducing the risk faced by the investor and saver. The existence of financial institution will help to minimize any possible risk arise during the transaction as it occurs through specialist financial institutions that serve as intermediaries between unit involved.
Assalamualaikum, my name is Hani. Now I'm going to teach you how to calculate chapter 2 of depreciation and taxation. First of all, before that, you must have to understand about definitions. Okay, definition of this chapter is the process of allocating the cost of fixed asset over the estimated useful life. And a non-cash expense whereby it is just recognition of the expense as the asset is used overtime. Okay, now we have to know difference between depreciations and depletion. Depreciation is deal with tangible asset, but depletion is attempts to measure the wearing away of a natural such as mineral deposits and timberlands. After that, we must know differences of depreciations and accumulated depreciations. Depreciation is the expense is calculated for each period, and it is considered as an operating expense in the income statement. But accumulated depreciation is expense from the first year until the present according year, and it is found in a balance sheet. And there are three methods of depreciation. First is straight line method, second is double declining balance method, and lastly, sum of the year digit method. Straight line method is the method depreciation is allocated equally over the estimated life of the asset. Formula for this method is cost minus salvage value divided is full life. First step is you have to find cost of asset. To find it, you have to take purchase price of machines and plus to installation cost and transportation cost. Step 2 is to find annual depreciations, and to find it, you have to take cost of asset minus to salvage value and divide to useful life. And step 3, you have to construct straight line method schedule like you can see in table below. Okay, for double declining balance method, they have two formula, which is depreciation rate and annual depreciations. For depreciation rate, formula is 1 divided useful life, and after that, the total that you get, you have to multiply with 2. And for annual depreciation formula is 1 divided useful life and multiply 2 and then multiply with beginning value. And after that, you have to using the same example as straight line method and construct the depreciation for DDBM method. Okay, lastly is sum of the year digit method is produce more depreciation expense in the early years of the asset use. They have two formula, which is sum of digit and annual depreciation. Sum of digit formula is useful life multiply with useful life plus 1 and divided with 2. For annual depreciation formula is remaining UL and divided with sum of digit. After that, the total that you get must to multiply with cost minus salvage value. And lastly, you have to using the same example as DDBM method and construct a depreciation table for SYDM method. Next is completion of taxations. There are 8 steps to complete the total tax liability. First is accumulated depreciation, how many years the asset has been used. Example accumulated depreciation using SLM method is equal to cost minus salvage value and divide to useful life and multiply with use years. Second is bank value equal to initial cost minus to accumulated depreciation. Third step is capital gain or loss is selling price minus to initial cost. Note for this formula is if you get capital gains, you need to calculate the capital gains tax. But if you get loss, no need to calculate the capital gain tax. Fourth is step is calculate profit or loss equal to selling price minus book value, and if you get profit, then calculate tax in RAD. But if you get loss, then calculate tax saving. Fifth step is compute tax on RAD is equal profit or accumulated depreciations multiply to corporate tax rate, and you have to take the lowest amount between profit and accumulated depreciations. Sixth is step is compute tax on capital gain equal to capital gain multiply with capital gain tax rate. And seventh step is compute tax on EBT equal to earnings before tax multiply with corporate tax rate. And last step is total tax liability. You have to tax on RAD plus to tax on capital gains and plus again with tax on EBT. And done.
Hi, Assalamualaikum. My name is Nurul Najihah binti Marazai, and I will explain about Chapter 4 in Financial Analysis, which is Risk and Return Relationship. Okay, now I will talk about the definition of risk and return. For the risk is the potential of unexpected events to occur, and for the return is the reward we expect to get from investment. Next, I will talk about relationship between risk and return. First, risk is probability of not realize the expected return when making an investment. Second, every investment has a potential variability in expected return. Third, the bigger the chance that actual outcome may differ from expected, the greater the risk. And lastly, the positive relationship happen between risk and return, because higher the risk, higher rate of return demanded to compensate the risk assumed. Okay, we proceed to the difference between risk and uncertainty. For risk is probabilities of outcome that can be estimated or known, and for uncertainty is probability of outcome that cannot be estimated or not known. Now we move to three categories of risk preference investor. First is risk averse investor, which is investor who demands a higher expected return bearing a higher risk. Second, risk indifferent investor is require no chance in return for the increase in risk assumed. Lastly, risk seeking investor is accept decrease in return for an increase in risk. Next is type of risk. Type of risk has two types, which is a diversified and non-diversified. For diversified, it is risk specific to a particular security and can be eliminated through diversification. And for non-diversified, it is caused by events that affect the stock market as a whole, and it cannot be eliminated by diversification. Next is method for reducing the risk, which is take up insurance policy to protect against risk. Second, reduce the volatility of sell and fixed costs. Lastly, diversify the asset portfolio. Next is tool to measure risk. The first one is statistical indicator used to measure risk are deviation and coefficient of variation. Second, a high low standard deviation or coefficient of variation is associated with a high low risk. And last, I will explain about calculation of risk and return. And I'm gonna show you the formula for calculation of risk and return. First is expected return, which is bracket probability and bracket return. Second is variance, which is probability, open bracket, return minus expected return, close bracket, power 2. Third, standard deviation is variance equals square root. And lastly, coefficient variation is standard deviation divided by expected return. That's all for me. Thank you.
Hi, Assalamualaikum. My name is Nur Shahzad Amirah binti Ahmed Suhaimi, and today I will explain about Chapter 5 in Financial Analysis, which is Cost of Capital. First is Sources of Long-Term Financing. Sources of long-term financing have three, which is debt or bond, preferred stock, and lastly common equity equal common stock plus return earning. Next, what are the weighted average cost of capital, WACC, and weighted marginal cost of capital, WMCC? Weighted average cost of capital is a method used to find the overall cost of financing through the combination of at least two sources of financing, and proportionate weight is assigned to each sources of financing. While weighted marginal cost of capital is a method used to find the cost of capital when an additional amount of capital is raised. Lender may increase the cost of debt when the debt amount exceeds certain limit. Combination of sources of financing versus single source of financing. Each sources of financing has its advantages and disadvantages. Debt financing, for example, is cheaper than equity financing because the debt financing is tax deductible. However, equity financing is less risky as compared to debt financing. Therefore, the combination of both sources of financing will help a company to reduce its financial risk. Okay, now I will teach how to calculate of cost of each sources of financing. First is bond. Bond have two calculations, which is cost of insurance bond before tax, KB, and cost of insurance bond after tax, KBI. Calculation for KB is KB equals CR times PAR plus big bracket PAR minus small bracket SP minus FC divide N divide PAR plus small bracket SP minus FC divide 2. Calculation for KBI is KBI equal KB times small bracket 1 minus tax. Second is preferred stock KP. The calculation for KP is KP equal DR times PAR divide SP minus FC. DR is dividend rate, PAR is PAR value of 100 ringgit Malaysia, SP is selling price and FC is floating cost. And lastly is common equity. Common equity have two calculations, which is common stock KCS and retail earnings KRE. The calculation for KCS is KCS equal bracket D1 divide SP minus FC bracket plus G. Next, D1 equal DO bracket 1 plus G. D1 is expected dividend, DO is last year dividend, SP is selling price, FC is floating cost and G is growth rate. The calculation for KRE is KRE equal KCS bracket 1 minus PT bracket 1 minus BF. PT is personal tax rate and BF is brokerage fee.
Hi, Assalamualaikum. My name is Siti Nur Aisyah and I will explain chapter 6, which is operating leverage and break-even analysis. Firstly, I want to explain the definition of fixed operating costs, variable operating costs and operating leverage. So, what is fixed operating costs? Fixed operating cost is thus not vary proportionally with the level of sales. It remains relatively constant regardless of the increase in the sale volumes. For example, rent, insurance premium, and property tax. Next, variable operating cost it moves directly with the level of output. The cost increase as output increase. For example, selling commission, cost of raw material, and direct labor cost. And operating leverage is the responsiveness of earning before interest and tax, EBIT, to the change of sale volume due to the use of fixed cost by the firm. Now, we move on to degree of operating leverage, DOL. The definition of DOL is the percentage changes in EBIT resulting from a percentage changes in sale. There are three formulas to measure the degree of operating leverage. First is DOL equal percentage change in EBIT divided by percentage change in sale. As you can see, the example of the question can solve by using this formula. Second formula is DOL equal to sale minus variable cost divided by sale minus variable cost minus fixed cost. Based on the example of the question, this question can solve by using this formula. Third formula is DOL equal to X small bracket P minus V small bracket divided by X small bracket P minus V small bracket minus total fixed cost. You can use this formula if in the question give you price per unit and variable cost per unit like the example of question. Break-even analysis. The definition of break-even analysis is a method used to determine the level of sales that a firm must reach to cover its operating costs. This is the list of formulas in the break-even analysis. Lastly, this is the example question of break-even analysis.